Hey guys, welcome to Dev Take Finance, and in this video we would be covering the topic wealth cycle. This video is a part of wealth management module, so please don't forget to watch other videos related to this topic to get a better understanding. So let's start with the introduction part. So what is exactly wealth cycle stages? Here you can see two terms, life cycle stages and wealth cycle stages, and these both stages comes into concern when we talk about financial planning. So when we are doing financial planning, we need to analyze that the particular individual is falling at which life cycle stage and how is that life cycle stage correlated to a particular wealth cycle stages. So what all could be life cycle stage? You could be a child, unmarried, young, married, married with children. You could be at pre-retirement stage, retirement, post-retirement stage. And why does it matter to classify yourself at a particular life cycle stage? Because at each and every life cycle, you have different spending pattern, you have different number of dependents on you, you have different earning capacity according to your age, you have different expenditure depending on the people who are living with you. So this is how your life cycle matters a lot when it comes to your finances. And that's why it becomes important to correlate both life cycle and wealth cycle stages. So in wealth cycle stages, we can observe the formation period, accumulation period, transition period, distribution period, and intergenerational transfer. So one by one, we would try to cover all these wealth cycle stages and we would understand how does it affect your financial planning and what should be your steps towards getting a good financial advice during these stages. So basically, when we want to correlate both the life cycle and wealth cycle stages, we can see that when you are a child, you are basically in the stage of formation period. So when we are a child, we can inculcate certain behaviors that would help the formation of basic knowledge about wealth, basic knowledge about finances. So for example, from childhood only, if we were given the knowledge about how to do savings out of whatever pocket money we get and how to understand various prices of products when we are going to purchase with our parents, and understanding the importance of money, how that is earned and what should be the reasonable amount to spend on the needs and what should be the difference between when you want something or when you are in need of something. So these particular habits could be created in a child from very basic stage to give a basic overview about financial knowledge, to make your child smarter in terms of finances and to inculcate the habit of saving in your child right from keeping a piggy bank, putting your pocket money in that. You can teach all these things to your child to make him financially strong, to make him understand at least the basics of money. What does this mean? What is saving? And all these things, because the formation built for other stages in life. So the life cycle stage of child should serve as formation period in terms of wealth cycle. Now coming to unmarried young, so this should be the accumulation period as well as the young married. So unmarried young and young married should be the accumulation period, because at this stage of life cycle, you are not having any children and you are at early stage of your professional career. So this is the beginning of your job life. After you have completed your education, your higher education, now you are into the job, the corporate life. So this is the beginning phase of your professional career. And at this stage, because the liability on you is really less, now whatever you are earning, either you are spending on yourself or maybe you are newly married, so you are spending on yourself and your wife, so dependency is very less, and thus this period should be the accumulation period. So more and more you should try to accumulate out of your wealth. So you should try to invest the larger amount of your salary, and you should be a risk taker at this stage because of your life cycle stage, which allows you to bear risk at this stage. So this is why when you are unmarried young, you are falling in the stage of accumulation period. Now, when you are married with children or at the life cycle stage of pre-retirement, so you are somewhere in between the age of 30 to for say 45. So this age group and this life cycle stage is also referred as transition period, because now as you are having children, a whole family is dependent on you. So maybe your wife is working also, but still you both would be contributing to various needs of your home and the children's education. So everything now, newer expenses comes into picture, and suddenly your lifestyle will change according to time. So with your children's and with your wife, suddenly the lifestyle will change, and which will incur a huge expense without you realizing. So the same amount of salary and you would be end up spending more. So this is known as transition period, and this is the only period where most of the loans are taken by individual, like the home loan, the car loan, the education loan for children. All these things are taken during this period, married with children as well as pre-retirement period. Thus this wealth cycle stage is called transition period, because many changes are taking place at this life cycle stage. And so how to be ready at this stage to be financially strong, we will discuss about that. Then coming to retirement period, this is also called as distribution period, and post-retirement, which is referred as intergenerational transfer. So it is advised that you do not need to wait for your retirement, because you need to plan for your retirement right from the younger age only, as you may be having certain retirement goals to fulfill, and after retirement you may not be having a fixed income source. So to be financially independent and to achieve retirement goals, what you dreamt of, all these things becomes important to do a particular retirement planning. And this is also known as distribution period, and post-retirement as intergenerational transfer, because what happens post-retirement, you need to do the estate planning, the will declaration, because after your death, all the property you own that need to be distributed to your family members or to beneficiaries as per your wish, your businesses, who will handle that. So all these things should be declared in the will, or a trust should be declared by you, so that no problems occur after your death, and everything could be distributed equally among your family members, and to the right person the responsibility could be put forward. So to make all these things simple and not complicate all this thing, to be financially strong at every phase of life cycle in terms of your wealth, these wealth cycle stages and life cycle stages combination comes into picture. Okay, so whatever we have seen till now in wealth cycle stages, we saw about wealth creation, that was in the phase of formation period and accumulation period. We saw about wealth enhancement, so that was in the period of when we talk about accumulation period, and we talk about the transition period. So that is a period when wealth need to be enhanced, because the lifestyle is changing, different changes are taking place, we are incurring more expenses, more dependents are there, and a sudden lifestyle change comes into picture, and certainly many goals started approaching towards you, like your child's marriage, your children's education, and various vacation goals of your then home, buying your own house, taking a car, getting a car. So all these things comes during this stage, which is also known as wealth enhancement, which we read before as the transition period. Then comes the wealth preservation period. So wealth preservation and wealth distribution are mainly the period which is pre-retirement and retirement. So during pre-retirement, you need to be a little conservative, and you need to preserve the wealth which you are having. So now you don't need to be aggressive investor as you were at this stage, wealth enhancement stage. Now you could be a little lesser risk bearing and more conservative towards your wealth, because now you need to secure your wealth for your retirement goals, for various goals that are approaching. You need to reap the benefits. So after you have accumulated, you need to preserve. And then the wealth distribution and intergenerational transfer, as we already discussed about the estate planning, whom to transfer the property, all these things should be mentioned, should be planned and mentioned before only, so that no confusion takes place after your death and the property passes on to the right owner and to the right responsible person, if you want that as per your choice. So this was wealth cycle, wealth creation, wealth enhancement, wealth preservation, wealth distribution, and intergenerational transfer. Moving on to understand this stage of wealth creation or accumulation. So this is actually the early stage of your professional career, as I already discussed. So mainly at this stage, you are falling in the age group of 20 to 30 years. These are mostly the young salaried professionals with high propensity to take risk. So you would be newly married, or maybe you would be unmarried young professional. So this time you are having a high risk bearing capacity, because dependency on you is less. So whatever you are earning as your income, you can invest a larger proportion in equity market to accumulate more wealth and to enhance your wealth in a rapid manner. So here, here at this stage, most of the investors should be aggressive investor. When you are at early stage of your life cycle, you are having that risk bearing capacity. So you should be an aggressive investor, because here you can take risk and you can aim for higher profits, higher return. Now, the primary aim at this stage is long-term wealth accumulation. So that's why we are in need of higher returns, because the dependency at this stage is less, and thus we are aiming for more and more wealth accumulation. And also it becomes important, because generally what happens at this stage, when you are unmarried, you are young, and you are you start earning, you tend to spend a lot. You tend to spend a lot in living a lavish lifestyle. So other than spending on various things which are not really required just to show off, it's better to accumulate wealth and to aim for higher returns, so that these wealths could be used at coming life cycle stages when you would be really in need of that. So seeking ways to maximize returns should be the aim over this stage. And what could be the fund type and allocation at this stage? So it is generally recommended that you should invest about 65% to 80% in equity. Equity here is indicating the share market. So or it could be mutual fund. So equity oriented mutual fund. You can invest through that also. SIP, lump sum amount, or directly in share market. So anyhow, you should invest about 65% to 80% of your investable surplus in equity, and 15% to 30% in debt, and 5% always should be kept as liquid fund, as emergency fund, because that is always advised to keep you with yourself. In case of any emergencies, you could have it as cash or fixed deposit and you can use that. So 5% as liquid fund. And equity, as I told, you could go through mutual fund or directly invest in the share market, and debt about 15 to 30% of your investable surplus. Now, the maximum allocation of your money is in equity at this stage, because the equities have higher risk and so it can provide higher returns, and debt, as we know, are a little conservative fund type, so it provides somewhere around 8 to 10% of returns. So a little allocation should be there at debt and more allocation should be at equity. Moving on to stage of wealth enhancement or transition. So objective is to multiply or enhance the returns on accumulated wealth. Here also, so here you are at the phase of transition period. So many goals are approaching towards you. There you need to buy a house, you need to plan for child's marriage, child's education, and you are suddenly burdened with a lot of loans. So you need to enhance the returns on the accumulated wealth, and you need to do a proper asset allocation to meet various financial goals which would be approaching. And tax consideration comes into picture. So many times you would realize that you are at the stage of your career where you are end up paying a lot of taxes. So you need to invest in those asset classes which would help you save on taxes. So there are many assets which provides tax deductions under Section 80C. So you need to invest in those assets. So tax consideration at this stage comes into picture. Then debt management. If you have taken many loans, you need to pay the EMIs on it. You need to plan on what would be your, what could be your possible expenses where you can cut on, and how you could increase the payment of EMIs to get out of this debt burden. And all these things at this stage should be considered. And as I said, this is a transition phase where you are buying a house, you are planning for child's marriage, child's education. So there are several goals coming at this period. So it becomes important to manage all the taxes, debt, and doing proper asset allocation. Tax management, I already said that, so it's repeated. Managing insurance needs and plan. And insurance needs also is important at this period, because after this age group of 30 to 45 periods, 30 to 45 years, if you're going to take insurance, it would cost you very high premium, because the risk of your life, the risk of diseases to your health would be probably at the highest side. So it's really advisable to take insurance policies at the age of 30 to 35 years only. And you could go for the term cover as a life insurance, and for health insurance you could go for a family floater plan which will cover the whole family members. And thus, you could focus on the insurance needs as well, looking at the number of dependents on your family who would be affected if your life or health would be affected. So to manage the cost of all these increasing expenses of health and all, you need to buy the proper term insurance and the health insurance. Coming to the stage of wealth preservation, now this stage signifies that minimal risk should be taken at this stage. So this was the wealth preservation was the stage of pre-retirement, right? 45 to 60 years. Mostly after 60 years, you get retired. So this is the stage of pre-retirement. Now capital protection should be on focus. So you have accumulated a lot of wealth till now, whatever, by investing most in equity. Now you need to protect your capital. Whatever you have accumulated, now there is no requirement to take a higher risk. You should take lower risk at this stage, and you should establish retirement goals. So various goals which you have already made for child's marriage, higher education, this is the time where you would be reaping funds for that. So whatever wealth you have accumulated now, this stage signifies that you can use all those funds. So this is the stage of utilizing money accumulated for desired goals. And here you can establish your retirement goals now. So fund type at this stage should be equity. You should allocate 15 to 30%, because lesser risk at this stage is advised. So only 15 to 30% should be invested in equity market. In debt market, about 65 to 80%, because debt is a conservative market. It would be a little safer side as compared to equity. So most asset allocation should be in debt, and liquid should be always there at 5%, so that in emergency you can use this fund. Coming to wealth distribution stage, so this is the stage of retirement and post-retirement, and we already discussed that we were setting retirement goals at the stage of pre-retirement. So now we can accomplish the retirement goals. Whatever amount we have accumulated for our retirement, we can utilize that and create a fixed income source for our retirement and live a financially independent life. So this is mostly the age group between 60 to 80 years, or till whatever age you are alive. So transferring or distribution of wealth, estate planning is very important at this stage, so that whatever property you own, whatever businesses you own, that is properly transferred to the beneficiaries, to your family members, and the responsibility is given as per your choice. Will or trust declaration and beneficiary's declaration of property. This is also done so that mostly to avoid complicated legal proceedings after your death and your family not to stuck in all these to prove themselves to be the beneficiary of your property and all. So that this becomes important at this particular stage to do proper estate and succession planning. Thank you for watching. This was all about the wealth cycle stages. In further videos, I would make you understand about financial planning and various aspects related to tax planning, retirement solution, insurance, what all plans you need to choose, what all schemes you need to choose. So keep a watch on my videos. I would be posting that. Do like and share my videos. Subscribe to my channel, Dev Take Finance. Thank you all.